is the 18th day of January 2014 and a beautiful Saturday to you. Hello and welcome to our program Environment Today, and we do hope you're ever more committed to keeping your environment clean and healthy. On today's package, we will continue our highlight on some of the episodes of Environment Today we ran last year. We couldn't accommodate the much we wanted last week due to time constraints, so we crave your indulgence to sit back and watch. You will also have another opportunity to see the fascinating drama presentation put together by some Nollywood actors on sustainable environments, and some of your letters too. You shall find this extremely rewarding. Sit back and watch. I'm Nkoli Omoldu, your regular host. But first, let's see how the environment fared in 2013.
The problem with this community is ecological erosion. Once it's raining season like this, we have a lot of recurring problems.
And this gorge started, I spent almost 600,000 naira to stop this thing. If not, the building will have collapsed.
For these citizens, though no casualty was recorded from the flooding in 2013, living with this gully and the threat it poses to lives and property is enough nightmare. The year was also replete with cases of building collapse and the attendant loss of lives and property in most parts of Lagos metropolis, which forced the state government to set up a judicial panel of inquiry to determine the causes of collapse and recommend ways of tackling it. The year 2013 also saw the demolition of shanties by the Lagos state government in its bid to clear the emerging megacity of slums, forcing residents to seek refuge in makeshift structures and open spaces, a situation that attracted the attention of the National Human Rights Commission.
It is obvious that this environment is not good for human habitation. It is therefore the responsibility of government in order to upgrade the living conditions of the people and provide alternative places for them to stay while the government is upgrading the environment.
Pipeline vandalism was also rampant in 2013 in places like Arepo, where vandalism of NNPC pipelines led to an explosion, and also in Akute area, where holes dug by suspected vandals for scooping fuel were discovered by officials of the NSCDC. But it wasn't all bleak in 2013, as experts scored the environment high in terms of waste management, pollution control, and enlightenment campaign through sanitation exercises.
We have a rising profile in awareness on the need to improve on our environment. I think people are now able to link the social well-being with the environment and with the sanitation in particular.
They were able to reduce their emission to the environment. A lot of industries in this state have changed from diesel engine generator to gas engine, and that definitely reduced the emission of greenhouse gases to the environment.
For the experts, these feats must be scaled up and sustained in 2014 to ensure a cleaner and healthier environment for the citizens.
We've been doing a lot of awareness programs. We've been doing a lot of advocacy, going down to the grassroots to sensitize them, the standard we have on the issue of noise. You see, a lot of people do not understand the health impact of noise. With noise over 115 decibel and at exposure period of over 6 hours can lead to deafness.
We're scaling up our recycling program, and we are going beyond the communal recycling right now. We are going to individual recycling at household levels. We are going to start distributing the recycling bags to houses so that everybody can start doing the sorting at household level. So this year is going to be recycling at the doorstep.
They are of the opinion that a pollution-free environment can be achieved in 2014 if there is less talk and more action towards safeguarding the environment.
Every day, our environment is undergoing changes. Changes that impact and affect our world. Global warming, climate change, environmental pollution and degradation, desert encroachment and flooding are daily destroying our world and making it unsafe for habitation. How do we cope with these changes? How do we improve the quality of life through our environment? These and many more environment issues will occupy us weekly on Environment Today.
It's imperative that people comply with laid down environmental laws if we must enjoy the benefits of a clean and healthy environment. But there are certain habits which are outrightly unfriendly to the environment.
Join Nkoli Omodu every Saturday on Africa Independent Television, AIT, as we take an incisive and in-depth look at our environment. Environment Today, creating a better and safe environment for the world.
Food waste around the world now amounts to $750 billion per annum, with a level put at staggering 1.3 billion tons of food per year. The food wastage, according to a Food and Agricultural Organization's report, is not only causing major economic losses, but also wreaking significant harm on the natural resources that humanity relies upon for food. The FAO report, called the Food Wastage Footprint, Impacts on Natural Resources, is the first study to analyze the impact of global food wastage from an environmental perspective, looking specifically at its consequences for the climate, water, land use, and biodiversity. As a general trend, developing countries suffer more food losses during agricultural production, while food waste at the retail and consumer level appears higher in middle and high-income regions. It accounts for 31 to 39% of total wastage than in low-income regions. Fruit wastage contributes significantly to water waste in Asia, Latin America, and Europe, mainly as a result of extremely high wastage levels. Statistics from the National Housing Policy released in 2006 shows that the building industry has an output of roughly 11% gross domestic product GDP and generates around 1/3% of employment nationwide. Yet, the industry is bedeviled with enormous challenges ranging from unethical practices in various stages of project delivery, use of poor and substandard materials, as well as quackery. These, experts say, have hampered the growth of the industry, considered by many as one of the pillars of the domestic economy. It is in a bid to address these challenges that the builders gathered in Abuja to take stock of their activities in the last 1 year and set goals towards transforming the industry.
This year's conference has been embellished with an exhibition program to give us all the opportunity of expositions in the new and latest innovations in the science, materials, and technology in the construction industry. This is my sincere hope that at the end of the day, we'll be more enriched knowledge-wise, more informed of latest development in the industry, and would have added value to the price of the building profession.
It was fascinating and inspiring to me. It is fascinating because it underscores the need to transform the building industry for sustainable national development.
The conference theme is Transformation of Building Industry, Possibilities and Realities. As some of you may be aware, the Nigeria Institute of Building, the Nigeria Institute of Builders, is the professional body for builders and those who are about to be engaged in the building profession.
The conference, which has as its theme Transformation of the Building Industry, Possibilities and Realities, brought together thousands of builders from all parts of the country. Indiscriminate disposal of refuse and wastewater discharge, dumping of refuse in water drainage channels, indiscriminate burning of refuse, erection of structures on drainage alignments or channels, spreading of clothes on streets and highways, air, noise and water pollution, hawking or trading on highways, and many others are all harmful practices that affect the environment and even the health of citizens.
let people be aware that some of these things are not right. Definitely, you are going to have resistance. Look, what is wrong with the government telling us not to do this, telling us to do these practices are not right. Apart from being not right, they sometimes dovetail into issues that we're talking about the climate change issues and our ability to actually deal with refuse collection. We dump anyhow, but if we were able to package all these refuse and place them, dispose them the proper way. You know, in some homes in Lagos, people dig holes into the ground and put all their refuse there. Their septic tank and everything. I know some homes around that we have seen under everything they dump there. They believe that government eyes will never be on them.
We deal with a lot of issues concerning the environment, waste management, we deal with pollution, we deal with the drainage issues, I mean, the issue of even water pollution as well. We deal with litters, we deal with a lot of, illegal structure, building on the drains, and so on. We deal with the issue of climate change, several issues that pertain to environment and so on.
Drainage is said to be a natural or artificial removal of surface and subsurface water from an area. Drainage system with open channels for the discharge of rainwater exist in most urbanized areas. The channels usually drain off rainwater into rivers or sometimes into agricultural irrigation canals. According to experts, an open channel or drain system generally consists of a secondary drainage system and a primary drainage system. The secondary channels also consist of a network of small drains, each serving a small catchment area that ranges from a single property to several blocks of houses. These small drains bring the water to a primary drainage system composed of main drains which serve large areas of the city. Both the secondary and primary drains are generally connected with natural drainage channels such as rivers or streams.
Now, if you look at this creek, it was designed originally to be a receptor so that when lagoon rises, it can retain some water so that the whole of Ijora and Ebutemeta and Surulere is not flooded. Now, what has happened over the years is that you now have illegal shanties, similar to what you are experiencing in Makoko, who have developed on the creek, now preventing the free flow of storm water.
For the experts, no city can be said to have been properly planned without proper drainage channels to allow for free flow of water. However, open drains are prone to blockades, as many see the drain as a convenient place for depositing solid waste, leading to dire consequences of flooding when heavy rains fall.
You see, it is rain that demolished this house. This is my own house. You cannot sleep again. If it comes in the night, you have to come out.
By the time of the rainy season, flood have been affected many houses in the area. So most of the people have been running away because of this falling of this bridge. So we are appealing to the government to come and assist us to do it.
For drainage to perform their roles effectively, there must be routine clearing, repairs in case of damage, and enforcement of laws regarding the use of drains. Open drains can also be covered with concrete slabs to avoid blockades and unauthorized discharge of waste and litters. And for the people, illegal occupation of open spaces and construction of structures on floodplain must stop if flood-free society is to be achieved.
Every day, our environment is undergoing changes. Changes that impact and affect our world. Global warming, climate change, environmental pollution and degradation, desert encroachment and flooding are daily destroying our world and making it unsafe for habitation. How do we cope with these changes? How do we improve the quality of life through our environment? These and many more environment issues will occupy us weekly on Environment Today.
It's imperative that people comply with laid down environmental laws if we must enjoy the benefits of a clean and healthy environment. But there are certain habits which are outrightly unfriendly to the environment.
Join Nkoli Omudu every Saturday on Africa Independent Television, AIT, as we take an incisive and in-depth look at our environment. Environment Today, creating a better and safe environment for the world.
I believe people should try as much as they can not to drop waste bin on the street, on the drainage, so that the erosion, the water could flow very well. So that's all I think you can do.
Some people, if they should see that rain is falling, they'll start pouring their dirt, and it will start block. It will block those gutters, so it won't be able to move.
And just you clear the drainage. You make sure that you don't pour dirt on in the drainage. You don't throw things in the drainage. So that's one of the ways.
I believe it's an attitude problem, so to speak. To a large extent, every vehicle in Lagos State, particularly the commercials, have a basket in their buses or whatsoever. That individual should drop the canned nylon bags, paper wastage and so on that is dropped on the roadside, that eventually find themselves inside the gutter and thereby blocking the drainage. I think it's an attitude. Most times people that eat all this stuff supposed to drop it inside the car where it is, either bus or private. When you get home, you dispose them properly. But that is not always done. Like my son, sometimes even when he wants to throw some of those cans out, even when I buy him drink, when I bought or when I drive, he wants to throw it. I say, no, it's wrong. Drop it inside. When we get home, we'll dispose it properly. So I think that's our little contribution to augment what government are doing. Because government, we are the government ourselves. Fashola is one. Lagosians, 15 million people, so 15 is to one. Then we are more. So if every individual should cultivate that attitude, the drainage is not for Fashola, it's for ourselves.
I see people urinating on the road. Like, especially those drivers, they come outside, they just bring out the urinating anyhow on the road. That will irritate me so much. Because women are passing, they will just, it rotates. Then there are another one again, number two. Those people that spit, that type of spitting that can rotate you early in the morning. No, I wonder, even men, sometimes I wonder whether they are pregnant. I thought it's only pregnant women that spat anyhow. But nowadays I see men spitting on the way anyhow. Even on top of Okada, they'll be spitting. Not minding whether people are coming, no? It irritates. They should be arrested. Giving some fine. Like that spitting on the road. At least they need lecture.
See, all people, they carry a dustbin put inside the gutter. It's no good. People go take, they go for that place to piss for gutter. It's no good. So many things like that. People say, if you carry a load, put all the thing where they shop finish for a house, we go put out for another person passage. That's why no good. So all that dirty way, the way then they put for quarter, it's no good. All that thing, if government feel do something for that one, I'm for happy, because all the road where then they do, now we they spoil up.
People smoking in the public places, it's a big hazard. So if there is anything government can do, so that if people want to smoke, there will be a designated place people should stay and smoke. That will be very okay. Thirdly, every nooks and corners, there is all these mechanic people. They are burning tires everywhere. So there's supposed to be a mechanic village where they will stay. Government will find a place for them. They will stay asket of the town, because all these gas they are bringing out is a big problem to people's health.
mẹ́ja ni.
Ọbọ̀ òun lórí tí mò ń sun lọ́wọ́
yìí. Àrí náà.
Kò sí kì í.
Èmi ò lọ́gí mọ́. Bíríkẹ́tì ni.
Bíríkẹ́tì.
Ẹyin náà ẹ wò.
Bíríkẹ́tì.
Rí sí, ó mú àwọn ọ̀rẹ́ wá sílé. Wọ́n wá ṣe ìlanilọ́yẹ̀ lórí ọ̀rọ̀ iná yìí ni. Wọ́n wá fi yé mi wípé gbogbo iná ilé ìfita ń dá yìí. Ó ń ṣe ìjàmbá fún ara wa àti agbègbè wa.
Kò sí èyí tá à ní gbọ́ mọ̀. Lórí ká máa yan ẹjọ́ òkú Èkó tà fáwọn oníbàárà wa. Ṣé ga jù.
Ẹ̀wò bẹ́ẹ̀mi náà ṣe kọ́kọ́ sọ nìyẹn tẹ́lẹ̀tẹ́lẹ̀ o. Ṣùgbọ́n mo ṣẹ̀ṣẹ̀ wá rí wípé n tó ń bẹ lẹ́yìn ọ̀fà ojú òje lọ pẹ̀lú iná igi tá à ń dá yìí. Gbogbo igi tó wà nínú igbó pátápátá tó yẹ kó máa ṣe èèyàn láǹfààní, kó máa ṣe àwọn èèyàn, kó máa ṣe ẹranko àti gbogbo àyíká láǹfààní. Pàápàá jùlọ rú ẹja tá à ń yan yìí kó lè máa pọ̀ sí nínú omi gbogbo ẹ̀ láti fi dáná pátápátá. Ṣé ẹ wá rí èéfín yìí? Ìjàmbá tó mú wá sínú ara wa kò dá pẹ̀lú àyíká wa.
Ọmọ mi náà sọ bẹ́ẹ̀ níje lò. Ó ní oxygen àti carbon dioxide.
Ìdí nìyí tí ìjọba ìbílẹ̀ Èkó tó fi fà mọ́ wa létí kókókó bí ìfàájì ti pé tí a bá ti bẹ́ ìjẹ ẹyọ kan nínú gbólulẹ̀ báyìí a ní láti gbé mẹ́rin pààrọ̀ ẹ̀. Tí a bá ṣì nífẹ̀ẹ́ sí láti máa mí ìmí atẹ́gùn tó ní àlàáfíà. Ǹdẹ̀ ẹ̀wẹ̀ ṣe wá rí gbogbo tí a wá ń mí sínú yìí lọ́sàn-án lóru inú ọ̀nà fún wa ló ń lọ ó sì ń fa ìdènà fún wa. Ẹ wá jẹ́ kí n pàkíyèsí sí nǹkankan. Ṣé ẹ rí ìdọ̀tí inú omi? Èyí ló máa ń ṣe okùnfà àjàkálẹ̀ àrùn tó máa ń ba omi rìn. Tóbi bá ń ṣọ̀la a máa bá a rìn.
Abálájọ tìjọba ìpínlẹ̀ Èkó fi ń gigi káàkiri.
Ó ti bẹ́ẹ̀
wọ́n fẹ́ kí a máa mímí atẹ́gùn tó ní àlàáfíà.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ ni.
Ọlọ́run ọba má jẹ́ kó rẹ̀wọ̀n
o. Àmì o.
Tí bá ti délé báyìí. Mo lọ gbégi kan. Ṣéǹkùlé mi.
Ẹyọ̀ kan ni wọ́n máa gbé. Bí n bá gbin mẹ́rin, ẹyọ̀ kan ò lè jánu mẹ́ta. Torí èmi fẹ́ràn atẹ́gùn tó dá fún ẹ̀mí mi àti àwọn ẹbí mi.
Ẹ wo ẹ̀yin èèyàn mi o.
Ìyá mi.
Ẹ máa polongo ẹ o.
A ti gbọ́.
Ẹ máa polongo ẹ.
Bíríkẹ́ẹ̀tì ni.
Ẹ máa polongo ẹ.
Yàrá sí. Bíríkẹ́ẹ̀tì ni. Bíríkẹ́ẹ̀tì tèmi
sí. Ní kíákíá ẹ máa polongo ẹ.
Bíríkẹ́ẹ̀tì ni.
Ẹ máa polongo ẹ.
And that does it for today. We hope we were able to refresh your memory. We'll begin our very fresh packages from next week. We urge you to join us as always. Until then, I remain yours sincerely, Nkoli Omoldo, wishing you a blissful weekend. Bye for now.